Every year, as the festive season approaches, more street vendors tend to pour on the streets to sell their merchandise. Even this time round, it's no different. Speaking to journalists at Media Center in Kampala today, the resident city commissioner for Kampala Capital City said they have decided to give the street vendors in Kampala up to 10th January next year to vacate the streets.
But because of this season, we gave it a second thought and considered to push it forward until 10th. But the operation is going to start. And we want to thank, there are some who have already started going to the markets. Please, we want to encourage all of you to really leave those streets.
Hudu explained that initially they wanted the vendors off the streets by 27th of December, but they decided to give them this grace period to sell their merchandise up to January. Because street vending is illegal, they have been asked to vacate the streets by 10th January next year.
The vendors and hawkers on streets should beware of next year. Our streets and pavements are not for vending. The government provided Usafi Market for that purpose. Please relocate to Usafi or to Wandegeya markets in peace before you are forced to do so.
However, as he addressed journalists, this seemed contrary to the directives by Kampala Capital City Authority, whose enforcement team instead intensified operations downtown Kampala, where vendors were ordered off the streets and those who resisted faced arrests and their merchandise confiscated. In another development, a tough warning has been sounded to those in the public transport system not to dare hike the transport fares. The RCC says government will not hesitate to revoke the license of such drivers.
I want to encourage police, my brother, the commander Kampala Metropolitan Tanui, and your team to continue regularly going downtown to the taxi parks, to the bus parks, to establish whether or not the operators have hiked transport fares. Any company that hikes transport fares, we are going to lobby the Ministry of Works and Transport to have it deregistered.
In the same vein, the public has been asked to keep vigilant by being very security conscious because people with ill intentions might again want to take advantage of the busy festive season and harm them. Story by Juliet Namwaya for the news.